Hello, friend. What date is it today, then, friend? December. What if one day I've spelt it wrong? Right? I've done it before. Sounds like it's raining out there. I don't know what date it is today. Because it's David's birthday. Beautiful. Okay. Are you having a drink? Can I get in? Thank you. And a bit more. None left if you keep going. Let's just smush that into there, I like that. Okay. So we've got the basics down. We are weighing in. In. Do you know what it's in, Frank? It's in Scorpio today. feeling today then? I'm happy. I'll start with happy. Happy to be here at my desk with my tools and my furry friend, Frank, drinking tea. Favorite mug while Frank partakes of some refreshing paintbrush water. Furry neck. Do you? Happy. I'll make you look a bit girly there. I'm going to use my little deck that I made today. Let's give it a shake. Oops, one's jumped. Let's have that one then. With that. Okay. How does that make me feel? To be honest with myself. things that I made. Got my name on there. Made them many, many moons ago, and the bag is very, very grubby. Doesn't sound great. So, let's have a look at them first. I made them with a branch from an apple tree that was in my garden where I was living. Paper I'll stick with. I don't know what that one is anyway, but it is. And so, I should put it here. I feel that this is quite important today. It is a message. A signal, and communication. Beautiful. So that obviously goes quite well with this one. It also can mean a mouth, which that just shows you how all this speaks to you. It speaks to me today. Thank you. My little cards. I'm now thinking, what affirmation would I use today? I'm thinking either be honest with yourself or sort of be aware of a message. Symbol for look or see, it's going to be a lovely eye. A nice simple symbol that we all understand. Oh, here we go. Frank's going to start destroying my kitchen cupboards. Frank, please don't. And while this dries, I'll go and deal with the cat that is trying to turn my kitchen cupboards into a pile of matchsticks. Anybody's got any hints and tips on how to stop him? I would appreciate it. I've had, how many cats? 4 or 5 cats in my life. And I've never had one quite as scratchy as this little one. Barricaded on my kitchen unit so he doesn't kill things. And I've been looking for some images to sort of strengthen the message that I've got today. I've found a really nice sort of serious, but she's looking you straight in the eye. So it looked like a sort of honest face. So I'm gonna pop that one on first. The trusty print stick. I love the smell of print. Wish they'd make a perfume that smelled like print. I would definitely buy that. Put her on there. She looks nice. And then I found these words. And I don't know why, but I just felt like maybe if we're honest with ourselves and we speak the truth, maybe new doors open and we get to do something that we least expected that we would do. So that's just the one that came to my mind. So I'm going to pop that one at the bottom here, and I've got one of my little monster cutout stickers, and I'm going to pop him there. So we'll pop him on first. Excuse me, sniffing. It's that time of year. Interesting proposition, swinging on a trapeze. Maybe if we are honest with ourselves and bravely speak the truth, maybe it opens up these sort of doors. So that's my little images all on. So the next thing I'm going to do is just a little bit of decoration. I like to use my Posca pens and my pen. A white one. Let's add some stars here first. I always like to put some stars in the sky. This one requires some sort of pattern around it. What shall I do? Oh, no, I know what I need to do. Gold. Gold. And I'm just going to go for some lines. And I feel like when I'm doing these decorated bits that I'm sort of reinforcing the art magic, if you like, that comes when you're doing these things. for yourself. You're thinking about the message that you've received. This is perfect for you today. And while you're doing these extra little details, you're sort of soaking in the message. That's how I'd describe it. So that it sort of sits with you for the day, travels with you, and you can look back at the end of the day. Or if you do this at night time, you know, some people are night owls, I'm an early bird, you can look back the next morning. About it. Do this whenever you like. I sometimes think, is this the boring bit? But it's not. I like the action of the repetitive things, which is like I say, sort of strengthening the message that's in your page and in your words that you've written. Excuse me. I feel like I want to make these letters pop out, so I'm just going to go around these. You'll notice I'm working on a writing slope, which I got from charity shop in a bit of a bad way, and I gave it a little bit of TLC, and I like to use it now because it lifts my book up to the right level for me, because I am short-sighted and old, so I have to have things at a certain height for me to see well, and also it makes it special in the morning that I'm using somewhere special to do this with it. And I feel like that needs a bit of something more. I'm not sure yet, but we're going to have spirals around this bit. Speak the truth. Be honest. Self. Really think. You want? How do you feel? What are you doing that's not in line with your truth? Where can you be more honest? Maybe you need to say no more. Maybe, this is me sometimes, maybe you need to say yes more. What does it mean to you? I like that. And then I've got a pink one here. Lovely. Oh, I know. Let's give it a bit of pink hair. I like a bit of pink hair. do first is choose the colours. I always choose the colours before I pick a card, before I sit down to write my thoughts. Colour is very important to me, and those affect our moods. And so in the morning when I think, what colour do I feel I need today? I trust that the first colours I think of are the ones I need. And they don't let me down. Right, I think now we need a little bit of colour on the monster. I think it needs to be, where's that yellow? Lost me yellow now. Where's that bloody yellow? There we go. Get a bit of yellow on for him. If you haven't got much time in the morning, like me, who gets up stupid early, mainly so that I can have this time to myself, but if you haven't got much time, you can use the same principles using crayons, markers, things like that, that you can just get out quickly. You can do smaller pages. Have to be quite so elaborate as me. I've done it before with just pencil, crayons, biros. It doesn't have to be super special painted, that sort of thing. You do what feels right for you and what and within what time you've got. It's important mainly to do it, not what you use, when you do it, and how you do it. It's that you actually do it. You do something for you, and caring for yourself. That's why I use these exercise books. They're cheap, they can be customised to make them pretty for you if you like that sort of thing. I am thinking about doing some customised ones and popping them in my Etsy shop at some point. And the paper is great, never bleeds, it goes all nice and crunchy, which sounds great. And it's like it's not precious. And it's not special, but then you make it special and you make it precious. So I think I'm happy with that one for today, and I hope you've enjoyed seeing my process. I've been honest with you, and I've not planned it or anything like that. I've just gone with the flow like I always do, so that you can see it real and not staged, because I want you to get out of doing something like this what I get out of it, and that is priceless. So thank you for watching. Go and do it yourself.